Hello and welcome. Next, I'd like to show you that how to replace this Toyota Yaris front brake pads, and then we continue. Okay, and first step is to take this our feel away and to lift up this car and be sure that you use in here specific those steel or some truck pallets that this car don't collapse against your hands and feet, and that is important to use security thing when we are lifting this car up. And first step is to open these bolts, and for that bolt we need 21 millimeter socket and little bit longer bar. And then when we open these bolts, it is easy to open, and now I have already opened little bit these bolts that they are then easy to rotate with hands. And this is this first job. And then when I have take these nuts in that way away, all of these four, we can take that feel away. And then remember, these nuts are very, very sensitive, and insert these in safe place, like some little bit upper place that there is no any sand. I insert my nuts in that kind of metallic plate. Okay, and then when nuts are away, we continue. Okay, and now all nuts are away, and then we insert our fingers in these holes in here and use gloves, because this job is very dirty. These are normally very sandy and oily, and that's good protective gloves like what I am using. We can easily insert our fingers in here and then only lift up a little bit and then out. First lift up and in that way. And this could be a little bit difficult to woman, but woman can take contact in her down area, like in that way. I will show that how woman take this, that first hand in here and second in up, and then we can lift that up. Okay, and then we can see in there this brake disc, brake pads and brake caliper in here. Okay, and then we continue. Okay, and what is our next task? Next task is that we need to open this brake caliper area, and it's easy to do so that I take my hand in here and then I only rotate that in this direction, and then we have next bolts in here what we need to open. And for that job we need 14 millimeter socket what fits in here so nicely. And then when I have a little bit longer tool, this bolts opening is easy, like Coca-Cola drinking, because it is so easy. And then I only rotate in that direction, look that direction, this bolts opens in that way. Now it's free. An idea is that I insert them here, and this is the opening direction, like in that way. Look how I rotate in that way. When I rotate, this opens, and then when these are these high quality bolts, it is easy to open. And there we have this specific Toyota's bolt, not standard bolt. And if this is damaged, please go to visit the nearest Toyota dealership center, what sells new Toyotas and also always new Toyota spare parts. And this costs something like $1 or euro per piece. And same idea in this lower area, that I open that also, and there's my tool. And in that position, when I open, this opens easily. And then I rotate, and then sometimes it can be so that this bolt is stuck, and this other bolt, what is in here, it moves also. I can show this part in here moves also, and in that purpose we need to insert this other new friends in here, what sides looks to be 15 millimeters. There is 1.5, if I remember right. Yes, it fits in here, and one hand keeps that, and second then rotates that bolt. Sometimes we need to do so that one hand keeps that and other rotates, and then this bolt opens. Sometimes they are a little bit stuck, like in here. It okay, and now two bolts are free, and then insert these bolts in clean place always, and my clean place is in here. They are now in there, and then next task is to take this caliper out, and normally when we insert our hands in that position and then we do that final movement, this opens, but not always, and that's we need to do sometimes, so that now I rotate that in that position, and then we need a little bit good quality screwdriver, and in that position there is small gap between in these parts. And then I bend in that way, and then, yes, they opens. These Toyota parts are the most well made in world, and normally this opens so easily. And then I carry and I insert that my brake caliper in that position. Look, in that place, it is in here. Of course, you can use some wire and insert in that upper spring area in here, there are hooks, it is also fine, but I insert that brake caliper in here, and then we continue. When we are doing this brake system lubrication and service, that what parts in this brake system in car or pickup truck or motorbike and motorcycle, I can lubricate and use this specific brake greases like that one, what is metal free paste, and there is actually picture that I can use these products, what is very hot and temperature resistant. It is like white grease, and this is specific products for brake parts. And in what areas I can install this stuff in my brake system, and this is my topic today. And first one, when we take this our brake pads, normal area is always that area in here, and in that area I can insert that my grease in all areas, in that outer area, remember, only outer, not in this inner area. And then these upper holes in that area I can insert this specific grease, and there is also some other grease what is suitable, but in that point I can install this grease. And what is the benefit? If I lubricate these brake pads, then these brakes works better, and there is no those brake issues, because normally when brakes become old and brake pads, then they become stuck and they are not movable, and then we have bad issue in our brake system. And that means, and these areas I can insert grease. And also in that areas, what are these support points where brake pads goes, and it happens so that I insert in my finger grease. And then, by the way, use gloves. Do not ever insert this grease to your skin, because these stuffs, they create cancer, and it is like poison. Always use this recycle specific, this gloves, but protect your skin. Okay, and in that area I can insert glue, this grease, and also in that upper area, this is fine. Then those parts move well. And then if this grease goes to this brake disc, like in here, use always clean cotton cloth and immediately clean those creases away, this disc, brake disc area, because it is wrong place. Okay, in that area I can insert, and then we have one area left. What is this brake caliper? And in here, in this brake caliper area, what is in there, I can insert this my grease in that area. I take more, especially in this area. And what takes contact to brake pads, this is good. And then this rubber sealant in here, I can insert even in that area lubrication. And there is actually a little bit better this brake, this rubber lubrication, but if we insert in there a little bit grease, it is not bad. And then that other side, what is in here, this area, I can insert in that area in here this lubrication. Okay, good. And then I can insert what is next when I have this bolts what are keeping this brake caliper in this position in here, and these parts goes in here, they are also good to lubricate in that way, that I insert in here this grease, and then they are really easy to install these bolts in back in here in that way, and then there is no any corrosion. And then final step is that if we have those, like in that car, there are those movable joint bolts what are in here, we can lubricate also these, because all moving parts needs this lubrication. And now I made so that I use only one this brake lubrication, but we have even very specific, little bit better greases for some of these specific points, like this rubber area and then these areas. But this metal-free paste is better than nothing, and the idea is that all parts move like in that way. Movement is the key. And the best way is to check that when we take our fingers, and then if they move nicely, everything is okay. And then if you notice that some part is stuck, then you need to take it out and lubricate. So easy. Okay, and now I think that I cover all of these main areas. Okay, and then when I am planning to replace these brake pads, next idea is to take these old away. And normally they are quite stuck, and we need that kind of flat head screwdriver. Look, this head is the key. And then we need to move this brake disc in that position, because it's easier to open, and then we insert that our tool in that hole in here, and then only a little bit bending carefully, and then in that area when we manage to do that kind of hole, then only a little bit movement in here, up and down, and now it drops away. And same idea in this lower part and brake pads in here. Okay, good. And then we continue. When we are doing this brake system lubrication and service, that what parts in this brake system in car or pickup truck or motorbike and motorcycle I can lubricate and use this specific brake greases like that one, what is metal free paste, and there is actually picture that I can use these products, what is very hot and temperature resistant. It is like white grease, and this is specific products for brake parts. And in what areas I can install this stuff in my brake system? And this is my topic today. And first one, when we take this our brake pads, normal area is always that area I'm here, and in that area I can insert that my grease in all areas. In that outer area, remember, only outer, not in this inner area. And then these upper holes in that area, I can insert this my this specific grease, and there is also some other grease what is suitable, but in that point I can install this grease. And what is the benefit? If I lubricate these brake pads, then these brakes works better, and there is no those brake issues, because normally when brakes become old and brake parts, then they become stuck and they are not movable, and then we have bad issue in our brake system. And that means, and these areas I can insert these. And also in that areas, what are these support points where brake pads goes, and it happens so that I insert in my finger grease. And then, by the way, use gloves. Do not ever insert this grease to your skin, because these stuffs, they create cancer, and it is like poison. Always use this recycle specific this gloves, but protect your skin. Okay, and in that area I can insert glue this grease, and also in that upper area, this is fine. Then those parts move well. And then if this grease goes to this brake disc, like in here, use always clean cotton cloth and immediately clean those greases away, this disc, brake disc area, because it is wrong place. Okay, in that area I can insert, and then we have one area left. What is this brake caliper? And in here, in this brake caliper area, what is in there, I can insert this my grease in that area. I take more, especially in this area. And what takes contact to brake pads, this is good. And then this rubber sealant in here, I can insert even in that area lubrication. And there is actually a little bit better this brake, this rubber lubrication, but if we insert in there a little bit grease, it is not bad. And then that other side, what is in here, this area, I can insert in that area in here this lubrication. Okay, good. And then I can insert what is next when I have this bolts, what are keeping this brake caliper in this position in here, and these parts goes in here, they are also good to lubricate in that way, that I insert in here this grease, and then they are really easy to install these bolts in back in here in that way, and then there is no any corrosion. And then final step is that if we have those, like in that car, there are those movable joint bolts that are in here, we can lubricate also these, because all moving parts needs this lubrication. And now I made so that I use only one this brake lubrication, but we have even very specific, little bit better greases for some of these specific points, like this rubber area and then these areas. But this metal-free paste is better than nothing, and the idea is that all parts move like in that way. Movement is the key. And the best way is to check that when we take our fingers, and then if they move nicely, everything is okay. And then if you notice that some part is stuck, then you need to take it out and lubricate. So easy. Okay, and now I think that I cover all of these main areas, but I need to install brake pads in here. And they are in here. They are in there. A second comes in here. That way, now they are in there. And then I insert brake caliper back. And bolts back. Okay, good. And then I fasten these bolts and then we continue. Okay, and then we need to fasten these bolts. Now when they are fastened. And thank you for watching that video. And now job is done.